Welcome back, young digital seekers. Hope you're having fun time learning. And I'm really happy with the kind of, subscriptions I'm getting and the number of kids who are actually trying. And I'm actually interested to see whether what kind of issues you're facing when you're trying to type your code in this editor and then whether you're able to run your code. I really want to know. Please do comment, about your success or failures in the comments down below. And it is okay that you get errors. Okay, so in this session we are going to talk about some pro tips for the newbies. So this is the agenda for today's discussion. So we are going to talk about all of these concepts. So first of all, we have to understand and embrace that everyone gets errors. It is not just you are getting errors. Everybody, even if a pro developer, gets errors. After 20 years of development, when I do some programming, I do some silly mistakes. But the only difference between a pro developer versus a learner is how quickly they are able to find out the issues and fix it. Okay, so it will come with practice. So that is the reason why I urge you to actually practice it more and more. You type more and more, you learn, the better programmer you will become. Okay, so trust me on this one. I have asked Anish to actually type the entire while loop and if conditions all by himself, and he did it 3 times in the past 1 or 2 days. So that really helped him, because initially he was making some mistakes and he was a bit panic because he's not familiar with the entire keyboard, and then the rate at which he types is a bit slow. But initially he literally took some time, he understood the keys, and then after the second iteration onwards he was able to type it faster because he knew the keys, he was able to quickly go there. So using one hand or two hands is okay for now, because you're all learning and you're all new to even using keyboards to that extent, which is okay, right? So don't worry. And making mistakes is quite normal, don't panic. All you need to understand is how to resolve that issue. Okay, so the common mistakes that we do are missing a semicolon at the end, missing some curly braces, stuff like this. Let us say you missed a semicolon on this line number 20. Okay, and you wrote all the program and then finally you click on run. What will happen? The compiler will simply say expecting a semicolon before balance, and if you click here it is going to take you there to the correct line number 21, right? So why it is expecting semicolon on this line whereas you missed a semicolon on line number 20? What happens is computer actually goes to the next line in anticipation that there is a semicolon there, but when it doesn't find it, it will simply say I didn't find a semicolon on that line. Okay, so to demonstrate this, let us add a semicolon on line number 21. So what happens when you run it now? There is no problem. Why? Because even if it is not able to find it on line number 20, it is able to find it on line number 21. So it is not a good programming practice, it is still okay that you can write semicolon in the next line. Okay, so let us type Anu and then end. So it works, the program is still working, right? So let us take it back to its original stage. Another error that usually we make is missing curly braces. Let us say you missed the curly brace on the while loop and then you ran it. What will happen? Nothing will happen. It is just going to throw errors on the screen, the red color ones. So it says cout does not name a type, expecting unified ID before return, and expected declaration before curly brace. So if you understand this, it is going to be clear. Why? Because what happens is while loop, when you don't have any starting curly brace, it just assumes there is only one single statement. So that one single statement is going to be your if condition, and after that it will ignore everything, it will just process rest of them as normal, and then it will go here. And it will consider this as the end of main function. Now you can demonstrate that by writing another function here, temp function, okay, and say you also have declare your int balance, because balance is used here, it need to be declared within this function. Now if you run it, it still works. Why? Because it is just treating this as a separate function, and this curly brace is assumed as the end of main, because you don't have any starting curly brace for while. But how do we know while is just considering this as your loop, one statement? That might be your question. Let us write, okay, so while it is running, you cannot do anything else. So you can click on stop and then you can type changes, okay? So let us write a cout statement here and then say balance is, okay? And then we will say, right. Now when you run it, so it is going to actually go into the while loop when you type anu, right? So when you type anu, it is going into the while loop, but it is printing so many times balance. Why? Because it is entering into an infinite loop. Why? Because it will just come inside with a visitor name anu that you have typed, and it will check visitor name anu is not equal to end, which is good. That's why it go into the if condition, anu is equal to anu, it will process the balance, it will type it here, and it will again come back to the while loop. Again anu not equal to end, it will again go inside, so that because we are not taking next value of the visitor, it is going to continue within this while loop forever. So to beautify our output, well, let us just add backslash n. Backslash n is actually for a new line character. So it will print balance is balance, and then it will go to the next line. So let us run it now. And let us type anu. So now what happens? It is actually printing in the next line. And every time it is reducing 500. Why? Because it is processing it. So let us just stop it. It is going in an infinite loop. And when you run it and then you type subu. Okay. Because subu is again not equal to end, it is going to go inside the while loop. It will never terminate. Okay, let us see that. And the value is always going to be 5000 because it is never processed. You are not seeing any output primarily because it is not even entering into the if condition. It is continuously running inside the while loop. Okay, let us execute it again and then type end. So it will come out of the while loop, okay, and it is asking for the visitor because we have asked at the end, asking for the visitor, and there is no other printing afterwards. Why? Because main function is completed, okay? So now when you are omitting the curly brace for a while loop, what happens? It is just going to consider the next statement as the single statement inside the while loop. Clear? Okay. So let us go back to the normal C. Let us just add this bracket, remove this extra function and run it now, just to ensure that the whole thing is still working, okay? So now we will say anu, funny, and then end to see the final result, okay? So now we understood the common mistakes that we make, like missing a semicolon, missing a curly brace, and sometimes you even you type single equals in place of double equals. We will learn about that in the next session. So what is the difference between single equal to and two equal to? Okay. Of course, one more thing that we have to understand is everyone makes errors. If someone is saying that they never get errors in a program, either they are lying to you or they are God, whether he or she is a God. So otherwise, it is highly impractical that you develop, you write a program and then there are no errors at all. So everyone makes mistakes, silly mistakes, serious mistakes, and then logical mistakes. So the quicker you learn and then identify the error and then fix it, the better programmer you are. Okay. So don't worry, over a period of time, you are going to become a good programmer. Okay. Trust me on this one. Next one is, how do you debug errors? We have just seen that writing cout statements, we will be able to understand where it is going, what is happening. So that is the easiest way to debug a program. For now, let us use only the print statement. So I have added a cout statement here to understand how the program is executing every time, how much is the balance left with me. I'm just printing it. So what I'm doing, cout, current balance after visitor, visitor is balance and a new line character. Okay, let us execute it now and then see how the output is going to come on the screen. So I say Anu and then Pani and then Shravya, right? So now it is, after every execution, it is also printing what is the value present with you. Current balance after visitor Anu is 4,500, after Pani is 6,000, after Shravya is 3,000. Now if you type end, what happens? It is going to print the final output. Family banker now has 3,000. Good. So this is how, let us just do the debugging for now. Okay, the real debugging using the debug button and then how we do it, I'm going to explain it in the next session, where we are going to talk about the control flow of the application. Okay, and another thing that we have to learn is shortcuts. So what are shortcuts, right? So the quickest way that you can type any code is when you're typing, it will already give you suggestions. So if you type busy, then it is already giving you visitor is equal to visitor plus. So it is actually going to give you suggestions. If you click on tab at that time, sorry, tab at that time, it is going to fill the suggestion for you. So if you type balance, it is actually giving you various options. You can actually use the down arrow to select, or just if you think the later, I mean the first one is good, you tab and then it will automatically fill for you. Okay, so this is one shortcut. Second one is double click, select a word, triple click, select a line, four clicks, select the entire program. For selecting the entire program, the easiest thing is Control and A. Okay, and you have these various shortcuts. And if you want to go to the end of a line, you click on the end button. If you want to go to the beginning of a line, click on the home button, and you press Control and then the right arrow, you move word by word. Control and left arrow, you move left word by word. Okay, shift and then right side, and shift and moving of the cursor is actually going to select. So if you are in the beginning of a line, shift and down, you are actually selecting downwards. Shift and up, you are selecting upwards. Shift is actually going to be sticky of the cursor, and then it will actually go to the selection. So if you want to select word by word, Control Shift and right arrow is actually going to help you select word by word. Okay, and then you have Control C for copy, Control V for paste. These are common shortcuts everywhere, so I'm not going to tell you that. And there are even more shortcuts which are specific to this editor defined here. To run a code F9, to debug a code F8. We'll talk about debugging in the next session. Saving a project, Control S, beautify the code, Control B. Okay, so the beautification is not really working out well in this particular editor. We'll talk about it in a while now. Okay, settings and then information, show settings menu. So these are various shortcuts he has given on this editor. When you go for a real editor, full-fledged desktop editor, you will have more shortcuts. But do I need to learn all these shortcuts? Not now. Okay, so over a period of time, you will learn it. So here he is selecting, select left is shift plus left. So I already told you this. Go line down, down, down button, down arrow, right? So some, some of these shortcuts are already clear here. So the more you use keyboard and the less you use mouse, the better programmer you are. So a better programmer hardly touches his mouse. You have to understand that. Okay, so the best way to learn these shortcuts is practice. The more you practice, the better you learn. Okay. And then single click, double click, triple click, four clicks. We already saw it, how it works. Selection and moving the cursor, this also we have seen it. Now the thing is, how do you indent the code? What is indentation? Indentation means giving proper spaces for all the blocks, so that you will quickly understand from the UI how it is looking, right? and following some best practices. So you generally write a statement in single line, and you start with a curly brace here, and the corresponding curly brace will be end of that particular indentation. Okay, and then you have your let us try the beautify thing, but the beautify is not really working out well. So it is breaking the function declaration into multiple lines, which is not correct. Okay, this should be in the single line, and then there should be a space here, and then while loop again. These are two different ways how you can structure your code. One is having the starting curly brace in the next line, and second one is having the starting curly brace on the same line as the block. There are people who are using either way of the coding, but it is okay. So this is my preference to have the starting curly brace on the same line. It looks a bit cleaner to me. So it is again your perspective. So if you think the other way is better, if this way is better, you can keep it like this. No problem at all. So both are best practices, no issues. Okay. So you always keep stuff on the same line for the same indentation. And now this is actually closing the while loop. This ideally need to be on the next line. That is how it should be. Right? And then you have your cout statement and finally closing the main. So now this is called better indentation. So now by looking at it, you know that all these if conditions are within this while loop, right? And all these statements are within this if condition. By looking at this, you will know. So that is why you have to indent your code properly, and all these statements are within the main function. By looking at it, you will know based upon the indentation. So that is the reason why you better have proper spacing for this indentation. Okay, and we also said that it should be else if, not if. I'll tell Anish afterwards, because once you have tested if a visitor is X, then you don't need to test whether the visitor is Y. Once it is successful, then you don't need to test it any further. Okay, right. So indentation is over. So what can we expect in our next video, right? So we're going to talk about the control flow, how computer is actually go step by step into your program and then execute. So it is more easy to learn it by using the debug button here. By using debugging, we can understand it better. So that we are going to talk about in the next session. And another thing is, what are the operators? We have used equals equals here, single equals here, minus, plus, and then not equal to, less than, these are various operators are here. So what are these operators and how they are going to be useful? So these are the things that we are going to learn in the next session. So stay tuned, don't go anywhere. Most of all, keep practicing. And keep asking questions. I am eager to see your questions and your where you stuck, so that actually I can help you out in learning and make you a better programmer over a period of time. Thank you for those who have already subscribed, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe now and hit the bell icon so that you will get notified for all our future videos. And stay tuned, keep practicing.